And we were one of the first to make ChatGPT available on Lingnan campus for every student and faculty and staff member. They have free access to ChatGPT. Now, our entire campus has free access to GPT 4.0, which is the next version, and also 4.0 Turbo. Okay, so with the Turbo, you can do many things other than generating text. You can draw pictures, you can make a poem, you can do any other things you want, and other than this video part.
在睇片之前，大家记得分享、赞好同订阅卓见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁你就唔会错过我哋嘅最新影片。
So I think a lot of the good speakers before me have talked about this research innovations, which are very, very important. The other side of this panel or this session is actually on educational innovation. So I think what I would like to cover in the next 10 minutes or so is to step back a little bit and see what we are facing in front of us as human beings, all right? So I think the title of my talk is on reimagining higher education in the digital era. Basically, about 2 years ago, maybe a year and a half ago, this ChatGPT and GPT are coming around, okay, from the horizon. So for the last 14, 15 months or so, I bet you have had a very different view about AI and digital technologies than you know, before November 2022. That was the time when ChatGPT was released, okay? So myself, I myself is a data scientist or AI researcher, so I think I'm sort of at the forefront of this technology advancements, and also I'm now leading this Lingnan University, which is a century-old liberal arts university. So what we are facing, what's going to change us is really something that's on top of my mind and also on top of many of my colleagues' minds. So I hope to share with you some of our you know, thinking and also practices at Lingnan. Okay. First, Lingnan University is one of the leading liberal arts universities in Hong Kong and also in Asia. Being liberal arts, we train and educate people first and then train them on surviving skills where they can make a living, okay? So that's a very important difference from a lot of other universities. So we are carrying the liberal arts education model, and also we equip our campus and university with both the facilities and also our educators with this kind of background. So we have a very good student-faculty ratio, and also a close relationship between students and professors and also staff members. We have a close-knit campus in Tuen Mun in Hong Kong here, okay? This university has been very much international from the, like a century ago. Now we have about 85% of our students having international study experience, and more than 70% of our faculty members are having an international passport. Okay, they have an international background. We have probably the highest percent of hostel beds, or this 寄宿式学校, okay. Initially, the campus was designed to have a one-to-one ratio of one hostel bed and also one student at the undergraduate level. That was the original design. Now our number of students has improved or about doubled since 30 years ago. So we don't have that, but we still guarantee at least 2 years of the undergraduate education life will be living on campus. With that kind of study, residential study experience, you can guarantee that they have almost all their time living on campus together with their peers, their student, peer students, and also with the faculty, with the warden, with all the tutors we have together living in the hostel, hostel buildings, okay? The other thing, last thing I want to mention is being a liberal arts model, our average class is 21 students per class. So I think it's a little too few. We can afford to make a 20% increase easily, you know, to make it 25 students per class. But anyway, that's our sort of potential to grow for the next few years. You probably know this ChatGPT was available in Hong Kong, and we were one of the first to make ChatGPT available on Lingnan campus for every student and faculty and staff member. They have free access to ChatGPT. Now, our entire campus has free access to GPT 4.0, which is the next version, and also 4.0 Turbo. Okay, so with the Turbo, you can do many things other than generating text. You can draw pictures, you can make a poem, you can do any other things you want, and other than this video part. So when I had this access to GPT 4.0, I basically asked it to do a few things for me. You know, Lingnan has about 130 years history, started in Guangzhou. Okay, so we operated in Guangzhou for 64 years before moving to Hong Kong. And another anecdote is that Lingnan University graduated the first female bachelor's student in China in the co-educational environment. That was 1921. So this is a historical. So I asked GPT-4, draw the picture of that student that graduated in 1921, but a female student, okay? So that's what I get. You see on the left, that's, of course, a generated picture. It's not real, but it looks like from that time, okay? The background, you know, it chose to do a black and white photo, so that all matches to 1921 time. The next one I asked was actually, how about somebody graduated from Lingnan in 1980. So you see that the girl on the second from left. So that's also showing this time. Okay, it's about 40 years ago. So then I asked, this was last year, how about a graduate from 2023 last year? Okay, so that's what I get. Okay, from in 2023, I had two pictures generated. One is an Asian girl, the other one is African. So the Asian girl is no question, right? We all know that's a typical Hong Kong student. But then on the right-hand side is something puzzled me for a second, but then I realized it's actually reflecting Lingnan University. We have quite a number of African students in our undergraduate, also graduate, and also in our, on our faculty. So this is something really deep about GPT. So they actually know what's going on our website, on our campus. So our African students are very active in, on the stage doing MCs or performing other things, okay? Just maybe a month ago, you heard about this Sora from OpenAI. And they are showing a few examples they can generate in a matter of a few seconds, okay? They can generate a video based on a prompt. So you say, you ask it to do, draw, like make a video of a young man in his 20s and sitting on a piece of cloud in the sky and read a book, okay? So if you just ask that, then Sora will do it for you. And this is the generated video, all right? And sitting on a piece of cloud, reading a book. So think about this, right? Now we're doing all the education in arts, in social science, in other things, even in sort of you know, media and other intellectual work. Now it's all done by the AI in a matter of maybe a few seconds, and then you iterate, it's probably several minutes, you can have something done, okay? So that's the beginning of what we're facing in the next decade or so, or even longer. So for us, for higher education, these are the questions I would like to ask. I don't have all the answers, but this is really what's coming, okay? One is, how will this AI affect our curriculum? Is it relevant to liberal arts? And is liberal arts education endangered? And then if that question is not enough, I'll say, what kind of education models will be in danger? All right, so we have a lot other students trained by non-liberal arts or specialized skill training, and that's a big question, okay? With AI, with all these generative results, some of them are not real, okay? They could be hallucination and so on. So then how do students obtain critical thinking skills with generative AI? So how would students be trained to tell something is not good, okay, not what they want, and then try to revise? So I would say classics learning. What we have been trained with the classics, with our history, our philosophy, our culture, that has to be there to build the value systems for our younger generations, okay? Will AI replace human? And also, will technology advances make them harder to use or easier to use? So these are the questions, okay? So we don't have all the questions, but we're making some practices and also addressing these potential future challenges. So at Lingnan, as I said, we make GPT 4.0 and GPT 4.0 Turbo available to everybody. Okay, we want everyone to use it to improve efficiency. If they have to make mistakes, we want them to learn what is a mistake if you use AI to make it, okay? We use them as a tool. Most likely it's revolutionary. And the answer to one of the questions is AI can be made easy to use, not harder, okay? In the past, say rocket science was made harder, but we're making it easier, okay? We think liberal arts education is more important because it really trains students with the creative and critical thinking, and that's more important with the generative AI that's available. Now, skill-based education will be in danger. Okay, if someone is, I think this is Jensen Huang from NVIDIA. He said just 2 weeks ago, he would not encourage anybody to study coding, computer coding, okay, because that will be replaced by AI. So then we want to train students with a good command of AI, and they can be more competitive in the marketplace. I will skip his talk and then focus on where we do AI training at Lingnan. Number one, we're making generative AI as one of our common core courses. That means students who come to our campus in year one, they will study these common core courses in generative AI. Our Faculty of Business is a leader of data science and AI. 5 years ago, we graduated first batch of undergrad already. We are also having other PhD and masters. We're forming a new school of data science. A month from today, we will have it launched, and we're hiring a new dean. And this school of interdisciplinary study is where we do a lot of AI for science, okay? AI for new material design. And the Faculty of Arts is really one of the leaders. And arts and digital science are working together. This program, Animation and Digital Arts, was the most popular program in Hong Kong across all universities and across all majors. So we had 40-to-1 ratio just for Drupa's Band A applicants, 40 applicants for one position. We are adding more programs, and I think we're still on our way, on our journey to sort of pioneer this innovations for education. Thank you very much.
鍾意名家分析，記得俾 like 同埋分享，支持同訂閱卓見名家，最緊要撳埋呢個鐘仔，咁就唔會錯過我哋嘅新片。